Am I audible?
Yes, teacher, you are audible.
Okay, thank you, sir. Okay, my name is Uma John. I am from Malad Municipal Secondary School. Welcome to you all. Once again, here I am saying thanks to our MCGM department and all the in charge. Okay, good morning. Okay, first, before we start our section, no, class, I want to introduce the topic. We always know some curiosity is rotating our mind, no? It automatically raises some question. That is good, no? That is good, and that is also one way, the positive motivation also. Why? Some questions, normally, it rises the children's mind. I know, because for this teaching experience, I come to know what are the questions, general questions related to the topic, it rises in the children's mind. See, in those questions are displayed here. Why convectional rainfall? It's not predominant in India. Okay, that means that convectional rainfall is not predominant in our country. Why? The next one is, Konkan region receives more rainfall while central Maharashtra is prone to drought. No? See, all over the Maharashtra, the rain is equal to everyone, no? But Konkan region receives more rainfall while central Maharashtra is prone to drought. Why? Climatologist names the cyclones. See, cyclones have names. That is very... Okay, sometimes the children used to think about for the fun, but beyond the reasons, today we will learn why metropolitan cities like Mumbai, Chennai are frequently affected by floods. See, we have all the facilities, no? We have, metropolitan cities means it is a developed cities. So Mumbai, Chennai are frequently faced flood issues. Why? So, this is a common question for everyone. Today we get answer from this module. Yesterday only I displayed the same picture only. We must know about for our Earth. So there is a climate zone, tropical zone, subtropical, temperate and polar. The tropical zone means the sun rays, it is directly reached the place. That is the center of the earth. The sun rays are perpendicular to the earth. Okay. And then subtropical zone, it is slight effect from the tropical zone, but the rays are a little slanting only. The temperate zone, it is more away from the tropical zone. In polar is northern and southern hemisphere of the earth. Rainfall. Okay, the general information about for rainfall, we already studied in our earlier, that is the lower level class also, 5th standard, 6th standard. We generally get water in the form of rainfall. The temperature of the air with water vapor reduces when it goes higher. Okay. Then now that is the contrast. This one what? When the temperature increases, automatically pressure decreases. Okay, then the air became very light. So it can easily uplifted to the upward direction. Okay, the condensation of the vapor occurs. That air automatically cools down. The clouds from when the condensed water droplets and dust particles accumulated. So everything together, it creates rain. The water droplets increase in size when they cannot float in the air anymore because of their weight, they came down as rainfall. on the basis of origin, rainfall may be classified into three main types: convectional, orographic or relief, cyclonic or frontal. Okay, this is the types of rainfall. So this is a diagram of convectional rainfall. See how they are nearer to the seashore. Okay, that air, the moist hot air rises. That means what? The air is already hot, but it is moist. Moist means it sucks the air from the sea. Water from the sea. That's why it became moist. And then air cools when it reaches the clouds, atmosphere. There is a freezing limit, that is a freezing point. So automatically the air cools and it becomes condensed. It comes like a rain. Okay, that's a normal conventional rainfall diagram. We go to the next one. Convectional rainfall means what? Hot air becomes light and rise in convection currents. Convection currents means what? The movement one place to another. Okay, and the hot air, otherwise gases or any fluid, it moves one place to another, that is called convection. Okay, here the hot air becomes light and rises in the convection current. As it rises, it expands and loses heat. Okay, when it rises, it expands because it is already what? It is a lightweight air. Okay. And then it easily expands and loses the heat. Therefore, the condensation takes place, forming of cumulus clouds. The cloud has many types. Okay, where there is the rains are forming, that cloud is called cumulus clouds. Okay, heavy rainfall accompanied with the thunder and lightning takes place for a short time. Wherever the convectional rainfall, okay, is forming or originating. It's the beginning of the convectional rainfall. These all symptoms are happening. Heavy rainfall accompanied with the thunder and lightning takes place for a short time. Convectional rain is common in the summer or in the hotter part of the day, especially in the equatorial regions and interior of the continent, particularly in the northern hemisphere. Same in the convectional rainfall, it is very common, but it is not all over the earth. Okay, as a especially equatorial regions, the equatorial regions only receive this type of rainfall, that is a convectional rainfall. Okay, the interior of the continent, the equatorial regions means what? The center part of the earth. Equator means what? The longest chord of the earth, otherwise the chord that passes through the center of the earth, that is called equator. So the nearer to the equator, that is the equatorial region. So always convectional rainfall, it occurs in equatorial regions only. And interior of the continent, okay, interior of the continent, particularly in the northern hemisphere, okay, it always comes. See here the example. I given the Amazon forest picture. Not only for Amazon forest, it's located in the equatorial region. In South Africa, there is a Congo forest. And then in Southeast Asia, see the diagram is showing, no? See first, Hawaiian rainforest, that is in North America, nearer to the Hawaii Island. Okay, then Amazon rainforest, Atlantic forest, that is the eastern margin, coast of South Atlantic Ocean. Okay. And then Ituri rainforest, that is like a same, Congo forest of South America, and Madagascar. Okay, that Madagascar is a very beautiful island. It's covered with full green. That is also comes under the equatorial forest. And Harappan rainforest, it is like in our Purvanchal, northeastern states, no? Continuation of the Purvanchal. That is the Harappan rainforest. And then Daintree, that is a nearer to the Australia, and above the Australia, the small island groups are there, New Zealand, so many island groups are there. There is also equatorial forest is there. And then see the next type of rainfall that is very closely related with Maharashtra. Okay, orographic rainfall. Okay, it is this is really wonder. This rainfall, no, it is also really wonderful rainfall. See, just imagine this is a cross section of Maharashtra land feature. It just imagine like that. The picture is already there in your textbook. Okay, that sea. There is a sea is resembling on that picture, no? That is Arabian Sea. You just imagine like that. That first red arrow, that is the Konkan region. And then that mountain is the Shayatri Mountain. Okay? You just imagine yourself, okay? In Arabian Sea, warm, moist air is supposed to rise over the higher areas. The air rises from the sea. Okay? That air, that is the, that air what, no? In our country, that Arabia, that is a monsoon air, okay? That is also southwest monsoon air. That air, red color aromatic, please are imagine yourself. And then that warm moisture forced to rise over the higher areas. It's directly rise up to the Shayatri Mountain. And then what happened? The air cools and condense forming clouds, okay? Then immediately the condensation is happening. The one side of the mountain, that is the western part of the mountain. So the rain falls more in Konkan region. Okay, now what happened? That air became very dry. It loses its energy or water or moisture, anything. Okay, then also it flows to the opposite direction, eastern side. There is a rain shadow region. Now we can understand, no? Why Konkan region receives more rainfall? But at the same time, the central part of Maharashtra is a drought-prone region because of the rain shadow regions. Air descends warm and became drier. Okay, thank you, children. I think so. You all understood. Then see the orographic rainfall. I just explaining after shedding moisture on the windward side as the wind descends to the other side. The temperature rises and increases the moisture capacity. Therefore, the leeward slope remains rainless and dry. The area situated, see that leeward side means what? Rain shadow region. Okay, when the air descends, the descending character, the descending side, that is called leeward side. Okay, and then see. Which get less rainfall, central part of Maharashtra, it's called rain shadow region. Then don't worry about for the central part of Maharashtra, it never gets water supply, don't worry. We have a big, the Shayatri Mountain is there, no? For the Shayatri Western Ghat is there, no? There we have many dams. So all the dams are overflowing. We have a nice irrigation system. So up to Kolhapur, okay, Ujjaini Dam. It's built on the Krishna River. So we get more water supply. Some areas still they are struggling for water scarcity. That we will study after that. Okay. The area situated on the leeward side, which get less rainfall, it's known as the rain shadow area. This type of rainfall is also known as relief rain. Because what? Why it is called for relief rain? See, the mountain. What? It is like a barrier. It is like a barrier to suck the rain, moisture air. So it is a relief rain. One side it gets rainfall, the other side is considered to rain shadow region. So then here I want to inform you in our Himalaya. Okay? I am always proud about our Himalaya. Really, I thanks to God also. See, it is a protective mountain. Yes. How no? The Himalaya, it doesn't escape the monsoon rains, monsoon winds to the northern direction. At the same time, it doesn't allow the Tibetan cold fraught wind to India. So it is like a protective wall. It acts like a protective wall. Okay, it is a barrier like a protective wall. That is also kind of goodness only. Okay, now see the examples. Okay, say this is India, how the monsoon wind rises, how it escapes, otherwise it travels to the other side. That orography rainfall, it happens in Konkan region, Maharashtra and Karnataka and Kerala. Okay, and see the same thing in Brazil also. So next year you will study about the comparative syllabus only, India and Brazil. But see, there is a Brazil physiography map. There's a Brazilian highland. After the southern part of Brazilian highland, eastern escarpment. See, that is also, there is a chain like a mountain structure only, upland system only. It also, the eastern escarpment, this also act like a barrier of southeast trade wind. So the coastal region of the southeast coastal region of Brazil, nearer to the southern Atlantic Ocean, okay, South Atlantic Ocean, it gets more rainfall. The Brazilian highlands, it became drought prone area. So now we are going to see the cyclonic rainfall. Okay, here I given the diagram. Just see. So how the cyclones are forming? Okay, the cyclones are forming in land also, at the same time sea also. So how it is forming? Just switch on your imaginary skills. You see, in the first I will explain to the land surface. If the particular area of the land, if any particular area of the land, it became very low pressure. Already I told you, whether the pressure is very low, the temperature is too high. Okay, the higher temperature, it automatically pushed the air to the upward direction. But the surrounding area, it's not a low pressure, it is high pressure only. That air attracts to the low pressure area. So the funnel-like structure will create. The air will uplifted to the upward direction. Okay? Then it pushes the cold air also. There is the condensation, it happens, then rainfall occurs. Okay? But how it happens in ocean, the same things only. In the particular place, that is a low pressure area. So the low pressure area attracts the higher pressure area. The automatically the air push the hot and 1 minute. Yes, the warm and moist air meets the cooler, more dense air. The region is known as front. Okay, whenever that warm air it's traveled to the upward direction and meet the colder and denser, there is a front will happen. Okay, then it forms the cyclone. That means what? That lower pressure area, it attracts the air. So that air became more fast because the air is already loose and lightweighted air. Okay, because of the fast, that is how much it traveled for the per kilometer, it considered to the hour, that considering the time limit. Okay, if it is traveling for the within the hour to 30 kilometers, that is very normal. That meteorological department knows, it always calculating the time of the cyclonic speed. When it crossed 40, 45, 50, it became too dangerous. That's why in our weather report, it showed the maps also during the cyclonic time. Okay. And then that width of the mouth, that funnel mouth is there, no? That also we have to consider, they have to measure. This all including, they will want the cyclonic effect, otherwise the cyclonic rain. As the warm air rises, it cools the water droplets which in the bold, dense and cloud form. okay, at the same time, it travels one place to another place with a specific direction, with a specific direction. So, and then it looks like a whirlwind. In India, we received more cyclones. Okay, the cyclones are not happen frequently in other part of the region. But India, like in countries, no, we received more cyclones. In recent cyclones, no, we used to call many names. See here, Vayu, Varda, and Kaja, and so many names we are used to keep. Why the meteorological department, otherwise climatologists, they used to keep names for cyclones? Because you see, the cyclones is not for the today's this thing. It were I'm telling you, it is in old and ancient period of time also. In earth, so many cyclones are formed. Even we were in school days, we studied for the Chola, Pandava, and Sera, that all the kingdoms, no, they traveled voyages some other countries through the sea route. They can experience many cyclones. They can experience many cyclones. Be given the names, we can read in nice historical stories and everywhere. No, we can see the names of the cyclones. Even Bible also, I read many cyclones names. I was wonder why they are giving for the cyclones names, because the width of the cyclone and the speed of the cyclone, we have to decide it is what type of cyclone, how much damages, otherwise how much effect it leaves. That's why they are used to keep the names. They can identify the cyclones through the name. Okay, that's why they are in climatological and meteorological department. It gives they are given the name for cyclones. See, now see the world distribution of rainfall. Yesterday I given the small quote. Okay, today I will be teach you little elaborate. Different places on the earth's surface receive different amounts of rainfall in a year, and that too in different seasons. As we proceed from the equator towards the pole, already I 1 minute. This picture. See, towards the pole, the rainfall is increasing. Okay, nearer to the equator, it is okay. Towards the pole, that rainfall is decreasing. Nearer to the equator, it is increasing. Okay, in equator, the pink color, no, tropical zone, there is more rainfall region. The coastal area of the world receives greater amounts of rainfall than the interior of the continent. See here the picture. So we have a 5 big oceans, no? Atlantic Ocean, Pacific Ocean, Indian Ocean, Arctic, and what? Antarctic. Okay, these all the oceans together, no? That nearer to the continent, we can receive more rainfall. We can receive more rainfall. Because of what? There is the more availability of water. The air easily sucks the water. The moisture, the wind, the speed, according to the speed of the wind. Okay? The nearer to the area, nearer to the coastal region, it receives more rainfall. The rainfall is more over the ocean than the landmass. The world, because of the big, great sources of water. You know, already with the last previous class also, yesterday's class also, I showed the 70.8% of world is surrounded by water. Okay. Next, between the latitude 35 and 40 degree north and south equator, The rain is heavier. That is nearer to the equatorial region. Okay, tropical region. Aisha, that picture, the pink color portion, no? So the center of the earth. The rain is heavier and the eastern goes, the eastern part of the earth, okay, like Japan, Asia, and South Africa, like that eastern part of the earth, it gets more rainfall. It goes on west, you know, it reduced. Okay, it goes on the west, what? It automatically reduced. That is the day and night circulation, and then how the sunlight reaches the place, the distance of the sunlight and everything it is determined. Not only for the single phenomenon, it has related to many other things. And then see, it between the 45 and 60 degree north and south equator, due to the westerly wind, there is also one more very interesting topic. This is the westerly rainfall. That means what? In our South Asia continent, no, we always experienced monsoon wind. Okay, but the same times, the western side of our earth, okay, like North America, in that side, no, westerly wind. Westerly means how we are having a southeast and southwest monsoon. The same thing they also having the south east and southwest westerly winds. Okay, but between the 45 and degree north and south of the equator, they experienced the westerly. This received the western margin of the continent's rainfall. Okay, so in that type of rainfall, it's more in western side of the continent. It goes on degrees to the eastern direction. Okay, so monsoon is more in eastern side of the continent. That the westerly winds, that is, gives more rainfall in the western side of the continents. You know the geological truth, all the desert, it forms western side of the continent. Yeah, you go and see the world map, in all the desert in India, okay, in all the continent, wherever the desert is there, the Great Australian Desert, and then in our Thar Desert, and then in Africa, very big desert, in African, South African desert, all the desert, it lies in the western direction because of that westerly winds only. Okay, now we are seeing the rain gauge, how to measure the rainfall. Okay, that is an instrument. They used to keep the instrument in open space where the rainfall is more. Okay, in meteorological department, we can see the rainy seasons in newspaper, otherwise other medias, they told this this much centimeter rain falls in that particular area. How they can calculate? Through this instrument only. The uses of rain gauge, it is used to study the present as well as the future condition of water resources. It is so what is the purpose? Just we know this much centimeter of rainfall is fallen in this area. Because of what? In all the dams and reservoirs are filled according this only. Okay. Then they can estimate how much water resource we have. Okay. That for the future, they can estimate through this gauge. Okay. It is used to determine the amount of rainfall with respect to the time at the particular place or area. It is used to predicate the water precipitation at the particular place to make stable structure like a dam, road, etc. Rain gauge helps to design the drainage by showing the discharge of precipitation at given interval of time. See, there is a gauge. It has a like a jug. Outer part is like a jug. That interior of the part, it has a funnel and it is inserted in the measuring cup. Once rainfall falls in the funnel, then it will be reached the measuring cup. Then the meteorological department, they have a calculating of the period of time. Okay, they can measure the amount of rainfall collected in the rain gauge. Okay. And further, nice information is given to about the rain gauge in your textbook. He please read that all. See, this is no. In our India, we have many proudness about our India by God's grace. Okay, see, this is the Meghalaya, that Mashram and Sirabunj, that is located in the Eastern Khasi Hill district, which is in Meghalaya state. It's the world wettest place on earth. Okay, wettest place on earth. The highest rainfall recorded in every year in this region. Okay. It is none other place, it is in India. So there is a rain gauge, how they are measuring the rainfall. How much rainfall it receives per year? See, 11,872 millimeter, 11,777 millimeter in every year. Okay. Then effects of rainfall. See, every natural, okay, that blessing is give some effects also, poor effects also, even good effects also. Okay, we know about for the good effects of rainfall, even bad effects also. See, the heavy rainfall will lead to numerous hazards, for example, flooding, including risk to human life, damage to buildings and infrastructure, and losses of crops and livestock. Landslide, which can threaten human life, disturb transport and communication, and cause damage to buildings and infrastructure. Okay, heavy rainfall. But in our country, India, like a country, monsoon countries, we are always expecting rainfall. Okay, because our agricultural fields, they facing towards to the atmosphere. Okay. And then acid rain. So it is too dangerous. Why it happens acid rain? Because our mistakes. Okay. In science and technology is increasing, developing. That is not a problem. But human interaction with the science and technology, how we are handling the technology, that is the main reason of this. Okay. How we are handling. We are only release all the harmful air to the atmosphere. Yes, really. Our factories, not poor maintenance of factories and land pollutions and the air pollutions, it leads to the acid rain. Acid rain or acid deposition is a broad term that includes any form of precipitation with acidic components such as sulfuric or nitric acid that fall to the ground from the atmosphere in wet or dry forms. This can include rain, snow, fog, hail, or even dust that is acidic. Okay, that is the acidic. Okay, became it is very too dangerous. But we have to the what control ourselves to use the two wheelers and four wheelers for unnecessary purpose. Okay, in our factories, they can follow the rules and regulation. They used to handle the proper method of that pollution control also. Okay, now let's revise the same questions. What are the questions? I kept it in the first slide, set induction slide. Only I keep it here. Why the conventional is not prominent in India? Because of we are receiving the, we are in not real nearer to the equator. Okay. We are in subtropical and temperate zone. That's why the conventional rainfall is not prominent in India. The Konkan region receives more rainfall while central Maharashtra is prone to drought because of the orographic rainfall. Why the climatologists name the cyclones? Because they can identify the cyclone by the name only. Okay, the how much effect the particular cyclones it gives. That's why they are keeping the names of cyclones. Why the metropolitan cities like Mumbai, Chennai are frequently affected by flood? It is a very interesting topic. You can find the answers. See, we are developed cities like Mumbai and Chennai. So why are they frequently affected by the floods? Because of our greediness. Yeah, we are building more dams. Sorry, we are building more bridges, flyovers, and stories buildings. This all leads to block the what? In block the flow of water. That's why it leads to flood. Okay, you can find many points through the Google also. Okay, today's our class is going to complete. Thank you so much. You have any doubt or any queries or any issues, you can ask me. Otherwise, send message to the chat. Okay, thank you, children. God bless you all. Okay, seek knowledge and wisdom. Bye. Okay, just you go through the slide. Convectional rainfall, orographic or relief, cyclonic or counter. Okay, just go through the slide. So I completed my class today. We'll meet on next class. Goodbye.